The Pergamon Museum is situated on the Museum Islands in Berlin. The building was designed by Alfred Messel and Ludwig Hoffmann. The building was constructed during the time 1910 to 1930.
It has different monumental buildings, which are the Pergamon Altar, the Istar Gate and the Market Gate of Miletus, that were remade from the ruins found in Anatolia, as well as Maharashtra Facade.
The museum opened during one of Germany's most turbulent periods and was largely destroyed in the bombings of Berlin during World War II. It is one of the most popular attractions in Berlin.
There are numerous treasures in this art and history museum that you would not think of seeing. The wall seems to stretch for miles as you look up at the art.
When the site of British Museum today is open the bridge, I will tell you about the Portland vase kept in the famous British Museum. Portland vase was discovered in the 16th century. The most likely theory is that it was the Roman amphora urn which was later cut down into the vase. The Portland vase was kept in the British Museum since 1810 in London. It is made up of white blue glass and surrounded with continuous white glass. Cameo making two distinct scenes depicting seven human figures plus a large snake and two beard and horn heads below the handle. Now I will allow Modita to speak.
I am Modita
Agarwal
from
7B,
and now
I am
going to tell you about the Rosetta Stone. This stone is one of the most important objects in the British Museum as it holds the key to understand Egyptian hieroglyphs. A script made up of small pictures that was used originally in ancient Egypt for religious texts. When I talk about Egypt, you must think why such an object would be there in the British Museum. It is because the British Empire had one held power in the Egypt, so they stole the precious stone from them. Though the Egyptian government has tried several times to get it back, but they failed. Now I will allow Anusha to speak about Kohinoor Diamond.
Hello, I am Anusha and I will tell you about the Kohinoor Diamond, also known as the Mountain of Light in Persian. The Kohinoor is one of the most oldest and most famous diamonds in the world. The history of Kohinoor Diamond dates to more than 5,000 years ago. Weighing it an astonishing 105.6 carats, the Kohinoor Diamond is described as colorless or fine white. It is believed to have been mined either in India's Kolhapur mine or one of the mines of Golconda sometime during the 1300s. The amazing diamond was 793 carats before its first cutting. There are also many myths about the Kohinoor curse. The Kohinoor curse is somewhat contradictory. It is said that its owner is granted the power and right to rule the world, but that he will meet with death and misfortune. But the interesting thing is that it is supposed to protect any female wearing it. Enough about Kohinoor. Now I will allow Dakshvi to talk about the famous historic mummies in the British Museum.
Hi, today I am going to tell you about the mummies of the British Museum. Mummification, magic and ritual are investigated through the objects on display here. These include mummies, coffins, funerary masks, portraits and other items designed to be buried with the deceased. It's amazing that any Egyptian mummies have survived to be preserved in the British Museum. Over the centuries, thousands have been destroyed through superstition and morbid curiosity. In the 18th century, mummy, the powdered flesh and bone of the Egyptian dead, was swallowed as medicine. Talking about mummies gives me shivers. This journey of interesting artifacts was very fun. I also hope you enjoyed it. We know that there are more artifacts in the British Museum, but these four really caught your eye. Thank you.
Hello everyone. My name is Abhinav and I am a student in grade 7 in GD Goenka World School. During this lockdown situation, our school gave us this opportunity to have virtual tour among the top 12 museums of the world. There were many new things which I got to know about the ancient world. I went through all the 12 museums, and the one which I found the most interesting was the British Museum. It is a well-known museum located in London. This had information about the continents, their religion and beliefs, art and designs, trade and conflicts, and their strengths. I also gained knowledge about the Mughal India, Japanese civilization, Chinese civilization, and Islam in the Middle East. It also had primary sources or artifacts about the Asian civilizations, like bronze Hu and the pottery with the dragon handle by Chinese civilization, samurai over armor coat by the Japanese civilization, Mughal paintings, the tankyard from the Islam civilization. I would like to thank my school for giving us this opportunity and making us all knowledgeable. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Mirels and I'm from Mozambique in grade 7. I'm here today to talk about the virtual heritage walk. I would like to thank my school for giving us this opportunity to know other continents and museums better. I today will be talking about the Asian continent as I picked it as my favorite continent. I chose Asia because they were creative and believed in their religion. They made statues of their gods and for their prayers. They were strict and respected their religion. Here I found the most interesting things that were the Padmasambhava. This was a person known for bringing back the Tantri Buddhists from the northern India to Tibet and in the late 8th centuries. And the other thing I found interesting was the stoneware kundika. This was used in the Buddhist religion. It was used in their rituals. This was a bottle-like structure. And this was about my virtual heritage walk video.